Hello everybody, I am E. Krishnarao Patro. Today I discuss about the questions related to our second module, related to stacks, queues, priority queue, and their infix to postfix conversion, and different types of express and representation. All the questions related to this, we'll see now. Linear queue, circular queue, whatever topics are in the second module, those questions now discuss one by one. The first question, simplest question, and in the most of time they'll ask in the exam, what is stack? A stack is an ordered list. It is a ordered list in which all insertion and deletions are made at one end, called top. So in a stack, you will be doing insertion as well as deletion at one side, that is called top side. So stack is a last in first out list, LIFO list. Remember, the other name of stack is LIFO, last in first out, LIFO list. And push and pop are the two operations that are used for insertion of element in the stack and removal element of the stack. So this is the simplest answer. Most of them they'll ask what is stack and how stacks are useful and what are the operations are there in stack. Then you have to answer this way. A stack is a ordered list. Remember the word ordered list, in which insertion and deletions are made at one end, that is called top. That means when you say stack, always you have to imagine a vertical bar. There you can do insertion. This insertion is nothing but called push. And whenever you say removing, that is nothing called pop. So these are the two standard operations for the stack. So push and pop operations are used for insertion into the stack as well as removing element from the stack. Fine. These are the two standard operations. And stack is one type of linear data structure. So remember, they may ask a question, stack comes under what type of data structure? Then you should say it is a linear data structure. Linear data structure. And I think in the previous session I told you the data structures are broadly divided into two types. One is linear, another one is non-linear. Under linear, you will find stack. The stacks are used in many areas. So depending upon the question, you have to answer in this way. Next question, they will ask what is queue. And remember, whenever they are asking any question, you have to write some text as well as you have to write some diagrams also, because the diagram speaks a lot. Means one diagram speaks about 1000 words. So represent the text at the same time, put the diagram also. So when they are asking what is queue, then you should say queue is a sequential organization of data. A queue is a first in, first out type of data structure. An element is inserted at last position. An element is always taken from the first position. And this side is called rear side. And this side is called front side. So in rear side, you will do insertion. That is called NQ. NQ is the operation which is nothing but insertion. Insertion always done at the rear side. Similarly, deletion. Deletion done at the front side. That is front side. That is deletion. That is called DQ. So DQ and NQ are the two standard operation. Okay, and queue also one type of linear data structure. So you should write a queue is a linear structure which follows first in first out principle, and it allows two operation. One is NQ, second one is DQ. NQ means insertion at rear side, DQ means deletion at front side. So this is the simple way of writing, and please write the diagram also and put the front here and put the rear at the end. Front will be always put into first element and rear will be always put into last element. And whenever you want to delete, it will take the first element, because the name indicates what? FIFO, first in, first out. Whichever element inserted first, that will be removed first. That means what? 25 came first, then 30, and then 51, and then 60, and then 85. So depending upon the order, that deletion will be done in that way. Okay. The next question: what method is used to place a value onto the top of the stack? So whenever you want to insert some data into the stack, so which operation you have to use? Because when I say stack, you always have to represent always in a vertical box. So whenever you want to insert the top of the stack, so there is a top indicator. Wherever top is there, you have to insert. That operation is called push operation. Remember, the other name of insertion for stack is called push. Similarly, they may ask a question: what method removes the value from the top of the stack? Because most of them, they will ask the question in the reverse way, in the indirect way. Instead of asking directly, they will ask indirectly: which method removes the value from the top of the stack? Then the answer is pop method. Pop method is useful to remove the element. From where it will remove? Always remember, when I say pop, it will remove from the top of the stack only. You cannot remove from the middle, or you cannot remove from the last. So pop method always removes from the top of the stack. Or sometimes they may ask a question: what is the time complexity to push data onto the top of the stack? Then you should say, because it is going directly to the position, which takes constant time. So whenever it takes constant amount of time, the time complexity is order of 1. Similarly, for pop operation also, what is the time complexity? Because in the pop also, you have to remove from the top of the stack. Directly, you know the position. So if you know the position directly, then you can, it will take constant time. So here also, it is order of 1. So these are the time complexity factor. Time complexity. Of course, you need not write all, but sometimes the question they may ask in a twisted way. So based upon the question, you have to answer. Next question, they may ask: write the application of the stack data structure. Where the stack data structure is used? Stack is used by compilers to check the balancing operations. So whenever you want to check the whether the equation whichever you written having the balanced parentheses or not, so those balanced parentheses you can check with the help of the stack. So whenever open comes, push it. Whenever close comes, pop it. So opening and closing parentheses must be equal. So those checking you can do with the help of the stack data structure easily. Similarly, stack is used to evaluate the prefix and postfix expression. So whenever you are evaluating the prefix expression or postfix expression, or even prefix or postfix, there also you are using stack. So stack is one of the important data structure for various purpose. Similarly, the stack is used to convert infix expression into postfix or prefix form. If you want to convert from infix expression to postfix form, or infix expression to prefix form, there also you are using the additional data structure, that is stack. So stacks are useful for various purposes. In recursion, I think I told in the previous session, in recursion also, the whenever the function is calling, that time push operation happens. Whenever the function is returning, pop operation happens. So that means recursion also uses stack. So in recursion, intermediate arguments and return values are stored onto the processor stack. So here also uses stack. Similarly, during the function call, that means whenever a function is calling and returns the address and arguments are pushed into the stack and return the pop off. So function, when you are calling with parameters, those parameters will be pushed into the stack. Similarly, DFS, depth first search traversal. Whenever you are applying the DFS for the graph, DFS uses a stack data structure to find the elements of the graph. There also you are using stack. So there are various applications of the stack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these 6 areas you should remember. So most of the time they will ask this question: what are the, or write the applications of stack data structure. This is very, very important. So I'll put a triple star. Very, very important. That means they may ask, what is stack? Depending on the question, if they are asking 5 marks, then you should write all these things. if they are asking only one or two marks, that definition enough. Whereas when they are asking elaborate but long question, then you should write all the detail. Or sometimes they may ask specifically this question: what are the applications of data structures? Stack data structures. Then you should write this. Or application of only stack. Then you should write all these things. So, depending on the type of question, you have to answer. Similarly, convert the expression A plus B into C minus within bracket D minus E power or exponential F plus G to equivalent prefix or postfix notation. So, if this expression is given, then what is the prefix form? And to convert to either prefix or postfix notation, then you can take the help of stack. So that means infix to prefix or infix to postfix always uses internally stack data structures. But here, how will you solve directly or in a simplified way? Though simplified way also internally it will be using stack. Now here what I will do, when you want to convert into prefix, prefix means this A plus B is nothing but AB plus AB bracket star C. Star C means, because this is star C, this is nothing but star of plus AB. This is one part minus D minus E. So, this is a prefix. So, minus DE cap F plus G. So, plus FG. Okay. So, now finally, this as the power having more priority. So, this you have to do first. Star of plus AB. This minus. This you evaluate first. Cap means exponential first. Minus DE plus FG. Then this minus will come front. So minus star plus AB cap minus DE plus FG. So minus star plus AB. Here our C is missing. So put C here. C. C. So, C. So, ABC cap minus DE plus FG. Yeah. This is your prefix notation. So, this answer. So, they will give the infix form. For this infix, what is the output? So, you have to do first this internal part so that you can get the answer easily. So when I say prefix, the operator will come first. So, that means to do this internally, it will be using stack. Fine. Similarly, what is the postfix form? So, to do postfix, now you see, same thing I will do now with postfix. So, I will erase out previous one. Now, to get the postfix form of this, first I will do this internal part. That means AB plus star C minus, I'll do DE minus, because the postfix. So when I say postfix, operator will come and cap FG plus. Okay. Similar this one. AB plus C star. So this part, this multiply minus, I'll keep this one because this is having high priority. I'll do this. DE minus and then FG plus this cap operator will come last. Then this minus will come last. So that means AB plus C star DE minus FG plus cap. This minus will come to last because this is one operator, operand. This is another operand. So, this minus will come last. So, you observe here, AB plus C star DE minus FG plus cap. So this is exponential power. Power in high priority. So that's a postfix form. So you got infix address, sorry, prefix address, postfix value, means postfix expression of the given infix. So this way you are able to evaluate. So most of the time there are this type of question. Similarly, they will ask define stack overflow condition. Define stack overflow. In that case, what do you have to do? Push an element into the stack which having already filled stack. That means if the stack is already full, still you are pushing. Stack is already full, still you are pushing. Then you will get a overflow condition. So overflow condition comes whenever the stack is already full. That time again, if you do push operation, there overflow comes. Assume if the stack is empty and if you are pushing some element, there is no overflow. So question is what? Define stack overflow condition. So pushing an element into the stack already having n elements whose size is n. That means size is n, but you are having already n elements. Then stack encounters overflow condition. The capacity of the stack is n. Already n elements are there. Still you are pushing. So that time overflow comes. So how will you check? It is checked by top equal to max size. My maximum size is n. My top also is n. So both are matching. So there if you are pushing, that time you will get a overflow error. So max size of the stack. Fine. Next. What are the applications of queue? Where exactly queues are used? The following application. Serving the request of a single shared resource, printer or disk or CPU. There is only one printer, but there are multiple jobs. So that means one job can use the printer at a time. So after finishing the first job, then you go to next job, So that means they have to maintain in a queue. So that means they have to follow first in, first out order, FIFO order. So whenever you are having a group of jobs, and but there is a single resource and they want all the job, they need that resource. So they have to follow an order. That order is called FIFO order. That FIFO order is followed by queue. Similarly, transferring the data asynchronously between the two process, that is using file or using sockets. So there also you need a queue. So these are the various applications of queue. Similarly, in consumer producer problem, whenever you are having a producer consumer, producer has to produce, consumer has to consume. Whenever producer is producing, you have to keep those items in a queue. So the consumer can consume in an order. So whenever resource is shared among the multiple consumers, so that time also you can use this queue. So example, include the CPU scheduling and disk scheduling also uses queue. When there are group of jobs which occur simultaneously and they want to perform this job, then you have to keep those jobs in a queue. So these are the various applications of queue. This is the seventh question. Now we'll go to next. They will ask, what is DQ? DQ also one type of linear data structure. DQ, the name indicates double-ended queue. See, remember there is a difference between DQ and DQ. This DQ is type of data structure, but this DQ is the operation. That means deletion operation on queue. Deletion operation on Q, that is called DQ. So this is a 5-letter word, this is 7-letter word. But this is uppercase, this is lowercase. So you must be very careful how the question you write. So when I said DQ, it is expanded. You can expand it. D stands for double, E stands for ended, Q, U, E stands for Q. Double ended Q. So D, E, Q, U, E, DQ. Double ended. D for double, E for ended, Q, E, E for Q. This is a type of queue which allows insertion as well as deletion in both the side, front side as well as in the rear side. Generally, in the case of normal queue, you can perform insertion always rear side and deletion always at the front side. But in the DQ, you can do insertion as well as deletion in both the side. That's why this is called double-ended queue. A data structure in which elements can be inserted or deleted at or from both ends, but not the middle of the queue. Middle of the queue you cannot do insertion deletion. Then that become a normal stack, said normal array. Whereas when you say queue, it would follow a order. So you can do in DQ insertion and front side, deletion also front side. Similarly, insertion at rear side, deletion also rear side. So whenever you are doing both operation both the side, then that type of queue is called DQ. Similarly, they may ask a question. And remember, this also comes under one type of linear data structure. This is also linear data structure. And what they may ask a question, what is the time complexity to do this insertion as well as to do deletion? As you know, both the indicator directly, so it takes constant time. So it is order of 1. If the position is not known, then if you want to keep on going from beginning to till that position, in that case, you have to follow the linear time. In that case, that is order of n. Whereas here, the positions you know already where you have to insert or where you have to delete. If the insert means the positions are known, that takes constant time. So whenever it takes constant time, then you should say order of 1. Then they may ask another question, what does stack underflow refers? Stack underflow, the name indicates what? Underflow, that means stack having no element, but you are doing popping. Removing item from the empty stack. Stack is empty, but you are trying to remove. Then that situation is called stack underflow. So that means here the top is 0. Whenever top is 0, it indicates nothing is there. So you cannot do any deletion. Remember, for stack there are two important things. One is underflow, second one is overflow. Overflow and underflow. Overflow comes when the stack is full, still you are pushing. Underflow comes if stack is empty, still you are popping. That time underflow comes. So these are the frequently asked questions you should know. And most of the time, whenever you are writing any application, there, if you at all you are using any stack, there you have to put a condition always. Because whenever you are inserting some data to the stack, while inserting data to the stack, you have to check always overflow condition. Similarly, whenever you are popping some data from the stack, that time you have to check underflow condition. So, overflow condition and underflow condition you have to check while pushing and popping. This is the general practice you have to do. They may ask a question, when you have to check underflow condition, then you should say under the popping operation. Or when you have to do overflow condition, then you have to say under push operation. The next question, what is the time complexity of pop operation when stack is implemented using array? If at all your stack is implemented using array, because you can implement the stack using even the linked list also. If at all you are using array, that means in the list, then time complexity for the pop operation takes order of 1. Why order of 1? Because the location you know already where you have to do the operation. As the location already known, that takes fixed time, constant time. So that's your order of 1. Pop operation takes only one end of the session, that is, hence requires constant time. So remember, that is order of 1. Similarly, they will ask a question, what is the advantage of priority scheduling in operating system? In operating system, there is a proper scheduling. This scheduling will be maintaining the those jobs or those process in a queue. That queue is called priority queue. Those priority can be changed with help of the interrupt. So interrupt handling, because the interrupt should be given more priority than the task at the end, so that interrupt can be serviced. So in the priority scheduling, you have to give more importance to interrupt, because it is giving more weightage. Similarly, now they may ask another question, what are the advantages of priority queue? The following are the advantages of priority queue. One is easy to implement. process with different variety can be efficiently handled and application with differing requirement as well as it is a real time scenario. Almost all real time application uses the priority queue because whichever event is very essential, important, that time those things you have to give more weightage. So the item which requires more attention immediately then put in the front so that that can be serviced first. There may be many jobs but only one CPU is there. So which is having more weightage that will come to front of the queue and from the front of the queue it can take and do the job. So that's why priority queue is generally used in RTOS in real time operating system. So in the real time scenario priority queue is more essential. So most of the time operating system uses this priority queue. Similarly, they may ask a question, what are the applications of DQ? The following are the application. One is scheduling algorithm used by DQ, means is implemented through DQ. Sometime you may give front or sometime you may give chance to rear. So in both the side I am giving full privilege depending upon the requirement. So there DQ can be useful. In the case of linear queue, what happened? Always you have to delete from the front side only. Similarly, you can insert at the rear side only. Whereas here in the case of DQ, you can insert left side, means rear side or front side. Similarly, you can delete front side or you can delete rear side. It can be used as both stack and queue. So you can use even DQ as a stack or as a queue because DQ permits, remember, DQ permits insertion at front side. DQ permits insertion at rear side. You can do insertion both sides. Similarly, deletion. Deletion also you can do at front as well as at rear. So that means whenever you want to do stack with the help of the DQ, then in that case I can insert at rear, I can delete at rear. These two operations I can apply. Similarly, when I say queue, then time I will insert at rear side and delete at front side. So that means I can use this DQ for both purposes, as well as stack as well as queue. Similarly, to find maximum of all subarrays of size k, so there also I can use DQ. So these are the various areas I can use the DQ. Similarly, to implement a stack using queue, to implement a stack using a queue with only one NQ and DQ operation, how many queues will you need? How many queues you will need to implement a stack? So here the answer is two queues are used to implement a stack using queue. Either push or pop has to be costly operation and costlier operation requires two queues. Okay. Next, they may ask another question. 15. In a circular queue, how do you increment rear end of the queue? In a circular queue, whenever you are inserting at the end, it should come to again front. The question is what? In a circular queue, how do you increment the rear end of the queue? So when you reach, because after inserting, every time the rear pointer is moving ahead. If the rear pointer is already reached to end, because in a circle, if it is a linear, the rear is keep on moving front to till last. So when you reach here, it is going out. That means always you are saying that r equal to r plus 1. If you write r equal to r plus 1, the rear is moving forward. But in the circular queue, it has to come, assume first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. Again, it should come to here. So after r equal to r plus 1, it should come to 0. That means this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, after 8 should come to 0. So that means if I write r equal to r plus 1, what happened? After 8 it will go to 9, but 9 is not there. it should come to zeroth place. So in that case, you should use modulus operator. If I write modulus operator R plus 1, rear plus 1, modulus the capacity, then automatically goes to 0. Here the capacity is 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After 8, it should come to 0. So that means 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 modulus 9. 9 modulus its capacity. Capacity is 9. So 9 modulus 9 is 0. That means after 8, it will go to 0. So that's why you should write this logic for insertion. Similarly, for deletion also, front equal front plus 1. Front goes in a sequence. Front equal front plus 1 modulus capacity. So this is the way you can do. So these are the various increment operation on this. Similarly, they may ask, what is ADT? What is ADT? Remember, this is one of the frequently asked question. The name indicates what? Abstract data type. An ADT is a mathematical model of data structure that specifies the type of data stored, the operations supported on them, and the type of parameters and the operations. Type of parameters and the operations. An ADT specifies what are the operations does and but not how to do it. So abstract data type tells about what exactly you need but not how to do. So whenever you want to represent what path but not how path, that time you can use this ADT concept. So ADT talks about represent the higher level details, but outer level details, but not the inner details. So typically ADT can be implemented using many different data structure. For example, I'll say int. Int is what? It is a primitive data structure, but not abstract data structure. Or if I say character, it is a integer, means primitive only. Float, because directly it will be doing the data fixed, which is primitive data structure, whereas non-primitive or abstract data type. Now, for example, I'll say stack. Stack is one type of abstract data type. Because when I say stack, in stack I can do other operations. Those operations I am not writing directly. So, one is push, second one is pop. Because when I say only stack, now I'll write here stack S. Stack S. On S, I can do push, I can do pop. Whereas when I write int I, when I say int I is directly data. That is not abstract data. Directly, you see, you store that. Here, in the stack, you can implement an array. There you can do the operations push or pop. So, the stack is a, comes under abstract data type. Similarly, I'll say Q. Now, Q is my object. So, to represent this abstract data type, you need object-oriented concept. All classes are used to represent the abstract data type. An abstract data type specifies what are the operations it does, but not how it does. Remember this word. It talks about what, but not how. Example of ADT, they may ask. Give an example of ADT. Then you should say Q is one ADT, stack is an ADT, or I'll say set. Some P. So set is a abstract data type, but P is a variable. Similarly, Q is abstract data type. And this Q is, similarly, stack is abstract data type. And my S is variable. Okay. Or they may ask another thing. For example, int I. Now, I is a abstract data type or not? No, it is a only basic data type. Similarly, I will write here char I or char j. This is also basic data type or primitive data type. Similarly, float f. It is also primitive data type or basic data type. Because these are direct. Whereas, when you say abstract data type, which the name indicates abstract form, it talks about the outer details. Now I'll say stack S1. Now stack is my data type. S1 is my variable. Similarly here, int is data type. I is my variable. But stack is abstract data type, whereas int is primitive data type. Similarly, I'll say q. Q is my abstract data type. My q1 is abstract, sorry, a variable. So why these are abstract data type? Because inside the stack, there are other operations are there, which are hidden. So abstract data type hides the internal details. So inside the stack, I am having push operation and pop operation. Those things I will not mention here. That is in the implementation side. Similarly, in the queue. In queue also, you are having the operations like NQ and DQ. Those things are not represented here because this is abstract. So abstract data type represents only what to do, but not how to do. Okay. Yeah. Now they may ask, what is circular queue? A circular queue is also a linear data structure in which the operations are performed based on first in first out principle, but the last position is connected back to the first position of the circle. This is the circular queue, but this is also a linear data structure. Remember, they may ask a question, circular queue comes under what type of data structure, whether linear or non-linear? Answer is linear data structure. Why? Because looks like circle, but internally everything will be stored in a contiguous order. You can go in a sequential order, in a linear order. That's why it is linear data structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can go in a sequence, in a linear. That's why it is a linear data structure. The index also starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the index also goes in a sequential order. That's why it is a linear data structure. And whatever the operations also you are doing, that also takes constant amount of time. And here also it maintains two indicators. One is front, another one is rear. So the front and rear helps you to do the operation like NQ and DQ. DQ means deletion is referred with help of the front indicator. Similarly, NQ means insertion is referred with help of the rear indicator. Okay. And the time complexity to do this operation also order of 1, because it takes constant amount of time. So whenever any operation takes fixed time, constant time, then that is order of 1. What is double-ended queue? Double-ended queue means what? A data structure in which elements are inserted or deleted at or from both ends, but not in the middle. It's called DQ. This is also one type of linear data structure. Okay. Next. What are the applications of DQ? Where exactly DQs are used? DQs are used in civil algorithm. It can be used both stacks and queues and to find the maximum subarrays. Now they may ask a question. What is priority queue? Priority queue is an abstract data type similar to the regular queue or stack data structure in which each element additionally has a priority associated with it. Every element is linked with associative means priority value, because based on the priority, it will change its position. The element which having high priority, that will go to front. The element having low priority, they will come to last. So that is the nature of priority queue. Even though in the case of queue, it follows first in first out, but here it will follow first in first out based on the priority. Whichever in high priority, that will come first, not based on the incoming order. It is based upon the priority order. That's why it's called priority queue. An element with high priority always served before the element with low priority. The element which having low priority, that will be done last. So whenever you're implementing priority queue, you have to keep the data along with its priority, along with its weightage. So this is slightly different from normal queue, because in the case of regular queue, you are storing only data. Whereas here, you have to store the data along with its priority value. So you have to maintain the priority. So composite data types required. Because while inserting, you have to check what's your priority. If my priority is more, then I will go ahead. So I will come to the respective position where my priority is meeting. If at all my priority is highest among all, then I'll confront directly. If my priority is less, then I'll at the bottom only. So while inserting, I'll check my neighbor, my immediate neighbor. If my priority is better than my neighbor, then I'll go ahead. If my priority is less, then I'll stay there itself. So every time you have to check the priority. Next, they may ask a question, what are the advantages of priority queue? The advantage of priority queue is easy to implement and process with the different priority can be efficiently handled as well as it solve the real-time work. It gives in the real-time world, priority queues are useful. They may ask a question, what is the time complexity of POP operation when the stack is implemented using array? I think I told you in the previous question also, the time complexity of the POP operation from stack is order of 1 because POP accesses only one end of the data structure and hence requires constant time. So whenever it takes constant time, you can say it is order of 1. That is the answer. If it is a bit question, you can write order of 1. If it is a little bit too theoretical question, then you have to write the explanation also. Next question. To implement a stack using queue, with only N queue and D queue operations, how many queues will you need? Two queues are used to implement the stack using queue. Either the push or pop operation has to be costly operation and costlier operation requires two queues. They may ask what are the applications of the where exactly the queues are useful. Serving the request and a single shared resource like printer, CPU and shielding. In real life scenario, all call center phone systems use this queue to hold the people and until the service dependency is free. Similarly, handling the interrupt in the real time operating system, especially the real time operating system always uses queue, not only queue, that is priority queue. So priority queue also one variety of queue. The interrupts are handled in same order as they arrive in the first come first serve basis. So it follows FIFO order. So especially operating system uses queue. Because in operating system there are many jobs or many users. So to satisfy everybody's requirement, based upon their priority, it will be maintaining those things in a special data structure, that is queue. Then what is the time complexity of the stack and queue operation? Stack follows last in first out and queue follows first in first out. The time complexity for push and pop operation is order of 1 and the time complexity for NQ and DQ operation is order of 1. So in both cases, constant time. So these are very, very important. So whenever it takes constant time, you write order of 1. But if at all any movement required, sometimes they may ask, search the element from the stack. How much time complexity required? Searching means you have to start searching from beginning to from bottom to till top. So when you're going from bottom to top, then it takes order of n. Search data from stack. Search from stack. Sometimes they may ask a question, how much time it requires or what is the time complexity for the searching operation in stack where the size of the stack is n, that is order of n. Similarly in the queue also, if you want to search from the queue, what you have to do? You have to start from front till rear part. So while traveling from front to rear, it takes repeated time. So this is also order of n. So when search from queue also order of n, fixed amount of time requires. Similarly, they may ask a question, how many different ways exist to represent an expression? What are the different ways exist to represent an expression? An expression may be a combination of operator and operands. So when you are representing operator with operands, you can represent in 3 ways. So answer is 3 ways. So what are the 3 ways? One is postfix, infix and prefix. For example, if I write here A B plus. That is postfix expression. Whereas if I write here A plus B, that is my infix. Prefix means plus operator will come first. A, B. So this is an example of prefix. This is an example of. So most of the time they ask, what are the different ways of expression representation? Then you should say there are three ways. Postfix form, infix form, as well as prefix form. And you can give one example for each one. Similarly, they may ask, which of the following is a valid postfix expression? They will give the set of expression, which one is valid. And remember, to check validity, the minimum checking is, you have to count number of operators as well as number of operands. The difference between operator and operand should be differ by one. Always number of operands should be one more than the operators. For example, I may say A plus B. There are operands are two and operators are one. So 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 operands and 1 operator. So that means the gap between these two is always 1. For example, I will say A plus B plus C plus A plus B plus C plus C. After plus, nothing is there. That means 3 operators and 3 operands. So 3 minus 3 is 0. So that means what? It is a invalid expression. So if you observe here, now here my question is, what is, which of the following is a valid postfix expression? If you observe here, A, B, C plus minus star. So that means 3 operators are there, 3 operands are there. So 3 operator, 3 operands not possible. So it is wrong. But here second one, if you observe here, A, B plus C star. A, B plus C star. That means 3 operand and 2 operators. So difference is 1. So it is valid. Similarly here also, it is a prefix form, but 3 operators and 3 operands. So number of operators and operands should be different by 1. So it is also wrong. And here, plus A, B minus C. Here 3 operators, sorry, 2 operators and 3 operands. Here, 3 operands and 2 operators. But the question is what? Postfix. It is not postfix. It is prefix form. So, it is also invalid. So, the right answer is B. So, you have to analyze which is the valid answer also. So, the first requirement is check number of operator versus number of operands. So, number of operands should be more than operators. How much difference? 1. As well as in the postfix, operator should come last. So that's why the B is written. Next, which of the following is a valid prefix expression? In the case of prefix, operator will come front. As well as here also, the difference between operator and operand should differ by 1 only. If you observe here, now see the second question. First option, A, B, C plus minus star, 3 operators and 3 operands. 3 minus 3 is 0. That means number of operator and number of operands cannot be same in a valid expression. So it is invalid. Next, A, B plus C star. Here operator comes next. But in the prefix, operator cannot come to. So it is also invalid. Now third one, please observe here. Plus minus star. 3 operators and 3 operands. So this means this is also invalid. Because it cannot be same. And if you observe the D, last one, star plus ABC. So, 2 operators and 3 operands. Yeah, the difference is 1. As well as number of operands are more than the number of operators. So, it is valid. Okay. So, this way. So, here D is the correct answer. So, most of the time they will give this type of multiple choice question. Then you have to analyze every option and do it. Next, they may ask, evaluate the following postfix expression. Evaluate, that means postfix expression is given, you have to evaluate it. What is the value? 2, 3, 4, 5 plus main star. So whenever you are evaluating, what you have to do? You have to use a star. 2 is operand, push it. 3 is operand, push it. 4 is operand, push it. 5 is operand, push it. So in the postfix expression, whenever you are evaluating, always push the operand first. Whenever operator comes, then pop 2. Now whenever plus comes, pop 2. So 4 plus 5, how much? 9. So 5 is popped out, 4 is popped out. So after popping out, apply the plus operator, and whatever the result comes, that result you have to push. So that means the 4 and 5 are popped out and the 9 is pushed into the stack. Next, minus comes again. Whenever the minus comes, again next one is minus. Minus is operator. Operator means again you have to do popping. So 9 popped out, again 3 popped out. So 3 minus 9, how much? Minus 6. Result is minus 6. This minus 6 again you have to push. So 3 and 9 popped out, minus 6, push it. Again star has come. Star is operator. Again pop out. So minus 6, you 2. Then apply the star operator. So 2 into minus 6, minus 12. So minus 12 you have to push into the stack. So now this minus 6 and minus 2 popped out, minus 12 is there. So that means at the end of the expression, the stack will be having only one element. So the result of this expression is minus 12. This is the correct answer. Okay. So this way you can evaluate. Or sometimes they may ask a question this way also. Evaluate this. So how will you evaluate? Similarly here also, we can take a stack. Now you see how to evaluate. Whenever the operand comes, you will push in the stack. So up to 5 we push it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to 5 we are pushing. Then minus star plus. So first you apply minus. When you apply minus, so 5 is popped out, 4 also popped out. So 5 and 4 popped out, and apply the minus. So 4 minus 5, minus 1. Whatever the result comes, again push it. So minus 1 is pushing the star. After pushing, again take the next symbol. Next symbol is star. So again pop out. So minus 1 is popped out, 3 is popped out. Apply the star. So 3 into minus 1, minus 3. So now that means minus 1 and 3 popped out. Put the result. Minus 3 is pushed into the stack. That means after doing the operation, that operation again pushed into the stack. So like this you have to continue for all. Then again plus has come. Plus means operator. So whenever operator comes, always pop. Minus 3, here 2. So 2 plus minus 3, that is minus 1. So minus 3 popped out, 2 popped out. So minus 1 is inserted. Again division. Division means again pop out. So minus 1, 1. 1 by minus 1, answer is minus 1. So the resultant is minus 1. That minus 1 again pushed into the stack. So that means when you reach at the end of the expression, the stack should contain only one value. So that is a valid one. So answer is minus 1. Similarly, this one, 5 star. So whenever this type of question, third one, please observe here. Third one also you can do in the same way. You can take a stack first. So whenever any evaluation comes, always use a stack. So 5 is push, 6 is push, then star has come. Star is operator. Whenever operator comes, you have to pop out and apply the result and push that result. 5 is popped out, 6 is popped out, star. 5 into 6, answer is 30. So 5 and 6 already popped out. So once it popped out, whatever the result has come, that result again push into the stack. So 30 is push into the stack. Okay. Similarly, 7, 8, they are the operands. Again push into the stack. 7 is inserted. 8 also inserted. Then plus has come. Plus is my operator. Again pop out. This. So 8 is popped out. 7 is popped out. And apply the plus. So 7 plus 8. Answer is 15. That result again push into the stack. 15. Again, the minus has come. When the minus comes, 15 15, then 30, 30 minus 15. So answer is 15. So that means 30 minus 15. So my stack is having how much? Only 15. So answer is 15. So this is 15. Next one is 3, 5, 7 minus minus 8 star. If you observe here, first 3 is operands. So first 3 operands again you have to push into the stack. Now you can do same way. As soon as the evaluation comes, define stack first. So 3, 5, 7 push into the stack. Then minus has come. When you minus comes, you pop out this. So 7 is popped out. 5 is popped out. 5 minus 7. Answer is minus 2. That minus 2 again push into the stack. Okay. Then again minus has come. When the minus has come, again apply the minus 2, 3. So 3 minus. 3 minus or minus 2. See, 3 minus up, minus 2. So that means 3 plus 2, that is 5. This 5 again push into the stack. Whatever the result has come, push into the stack. 5 is pushed into the stack. 5 is pushed into the stack. Then 8 has come. Again, push into the stack. Then star has come. Star is again operator. So pop out. 5 into 8. So this popped out. So 5 into 8 how much? 40. So 40 pushed into the stack. So that means at the end of the expression, you found only single value. So you can say 40 is the answer. So this way you can evaluate. So most of the time they will give this type of expression and they will ask you to evaluate. And they may ask a question, what type of data structure is used here? Then you should say stack. And then evaluate it. And before evaluating, first you check it. Number of operator and operands. The difference should be always 1. And operands should be always more than operators. Because these are all binary operators. For every single operator, there will be 2 operands. Next, which statement is true? First in, first out types computations are efficiently supported by stack. Stack is not following first in, first out, that is queue. Implementation of list on linked list are more efficient than implementing a list on array. Almost all the basic list operation. So this is true. Implementation of queue on the circular array is more efficient than implementing a queue in a linear array. This is also true. Last in, first out type of computations efficient supported by queues. Last in, first out, that means LIFO, that is implemented in stack, not in queue. So this is wrong. This is wrong. So these two are the correct. Because sometimes they may ask the true or false question also. So you have to read the options thoroughly first. After reading, then you have to analyze. After analyzing, then you say true or false. There may be multiple options also. So here there are two answers. Then my fifth one is the following sequence of operations performed on stack. Assume they will give the set of operations. Then what is the output? See now, these are the very, very commonly asked questions. Now what happened? Push 10, 10 is push. Push 20, 20 is push. Then pop. That means 20 is popped out. 20 is popped out. Then push 30, 30 is push. Then push 40, 40 is push. Then pop. So when you say pop, 40 is popped out. Again pop. So 30 is popped out. Again pop. That means 3 times. So 10 is pop out. Then push 50. 50 is push. Pop. So 50 is pop out. So that means now finally stack is empty. So what is the sequence of the value popped out? So this is the sequence. So answer is 20, 40, 30, 10, 50. So these are the order. So remember, because it follows last in, first out, before. That's why the answer is changing. Or sometimes they may ask a question, after doing this operation, what is the final status of the stack? After doing all the operation, what is the final status of stack? Then you should say, because after doing all the operation, stack is empty. So finally the stack is empty. If they are asking, find the sequence or what is the sequence of the popped out list, then you should say this. This is the list of popped out. Yeah. Next question. Which of the following permutations can be obtained in the output using a stack, assuming that input sequence is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the order? If you give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the order, then which is a valid one possible? Which of the following permutations can be obtained in the output? Assume 1 is push, 2 is push, 3 is push, then I am popped out. So 3 is popped out, 4 is push, again popped out, 5 is push, again pop out. Now that means out of 5, all the elements are push or pop. Again now pop out 2 and pop out 1. So that means 3, 4, 5, 2, 1 is possible. So that means this is the correct answer. See what is saying? Anything you can do, either push or pop. In which order? That is not given, whether you are pushing or popping. So, but first of all you have to push, then you have to pop. But the given sequence is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only. So if I give this data in a sequence, there you have to do push then pop. Either you may do pop immediately or you may do pop later. So which one is possible, it is asking. So answer is this. What are this one? 3, 4, 1, 1, 2, I is not possible. Because 1 has entered already early. It cannot come early. It will come last. So that's why it is not possible. Similarly here, 1, 5, 4. Assume 1 is inserted, again 1 is popped out. So, okay, 1 is popped out. After 1, how will you get 5? 5 will not come immediately, because after 1, 2 will come, then 3, then 4, then 5. So, when you pop out 5, 5 has come out. After 5, then you will get 4 only, but 2 is not possible, because 2 is at the bottom. So, it is also not possible. Similarly here, 5, 4, 3, 1, 2. If you observe here, 5, 4, 3, 1, 2. Why it is not possible? Assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everything I have pushed. When I popping, 5 is coming out, okay. Once 5 is come out, then next 4. 4 is coming out. 5, 4. Then 3 is coming out, okay. Up to 3, no problem. After 3, I will get 2 only, but not 1. Because 2 has come after 1. So, in stack, I cannot get 1. So, it is also not possible here. So, the correct answer is B. So, this way, I can get. Similarly, they may ask, what is the postfix expression for the given infix? So, if you observe here, A plus B star C. So, always you try to solve this within the parenthesis. So that means CD plus division F plus D into E. So that means DE star and A plus B star. So that means this you do first. A plus BCD plus star, this value, division F plus DE star. Now this you can combine. A plus BCD plus star F division. This is another one. Now plus D star, because these are all operands. Now this comes first. So A, B, C, D plus star F. Division plus this value plus DE star. DE star. So when you combine ABCD plus star F plus DE star plus. So that means ABCD plus star F division plus DE star. This plus goes to last. So this is the output. So that means this is the correct. So B is the correct. So you have to evaluate one by one separately. Always try to solve this within the parenthesis. Then you check the priority of the operator. And while remember, plus minus are having low priority. And multiplication division having next priority. And the exponential having high priority. So this principle you have to remember. If you apply this principle, then you will get the correct answer. Then next question. Which of the following is essential for converting an infix expression to postfix form efficiently? If infix is given and if you want to convert, which of the following is essential? They have given operator stack, operand stack, operand stack and operator queue and parse tree. So the answer is operator stack is essential. Because it has to maintain the operator detail in the stack, not the operand. So, while converting from infix to postfix, it has to convert based on the priority. So, those priority details will be stored in a stack. That's why operator stacks are essential. Sometimes they may ask a question in the case of evaluation. In that case, in the evaluation, you are giving importance to operand. There, operand stack. They may ask, the best data structure to check the arithmetic expression has balanced parentheses or not. To check balanced parentheses, for where every open there must be closing. For every open there must be closing. So to check this one, then you can use a stack data structure. Because stack will be is the best one. Whenever open comes, just push it. Whenever close comes, pop it. So opening and closing must be equal. So the push and pop operation can allow you to check the balancing conditions. So the stack is the best data structure to check the arithmetic expression has a balanced parenthesis or not. Sometime they may have a 3 plus 2 bracket. Now see, there are two open but one closing. So here what happened? Open is inserted. And this, when the closing comes, pop out. But there is no more closing. So that means after popping out, my stack having only one open. So open should not be there at the end. So when there is no corresponding closing, then one open is balancing. So it is a invalid expression. So stack is the best data structure to identify whether your expression is valid or not. So this is best. Okay. So this way you can verify all these things. So to evaluate all types of expressions, always you can use the stack data structure. So stack is the best one. So you have learned about stack, queue, priority queue, and circular queue and different types of expressions. Again, under expression, postfix, prefix, as well as infix. So, in postfix, operator will come last. In prefix, operator will come first. In infix, operator come in the middle. So you must know all these things. So these things you have to study. Okay. Thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.